Chris Barry from Communities at Work, and we're here at the Power to the People conference, which is all about building citizen-driven communities. So I'm here today with Denver DeCruz, and Denver is the General Manager of Social Inclusion. So Denver, before we kick off with our questions, do you want to give us in 60 seconds a little bit about your journey to today?
Sure. Thank you, Chris. Thank you for having me. So Denver DeCruz, I'm actually a Canberra boy at heart, so it's nice to be back in the capital. I grew up here, went to Marist College, and then did a lot of travel in my 20s. So I did my study at University of Canberra. And at the end of my travels, I thought, well, it's probably time to grow up and settle down a little bit and get a real job. So I moved over to WA to pursue some sporting ambitions. Cricket was my chosen sport. And from there, I guess one season turned into 10, and I'm still over there now. So yeah, and General Manager of Inclusion Solutions, which is a community development organisation doing a lot of work on the West Coast.
Thanks, Denver. So your work is around social inclusion. So what is the value of social inclusion? What is it? What does it mean?
Social inclusion means bringing the gifts out of everyone. It's essentially really valuing everyone's unique talents and what they bring to the party, and making sure that communities really do take care of and support people that are the most vulnerable people. In societies, we don't have a desire or a habit of seeing the value in people that are marginalised, and as a result, we box them away and put them to the side. So Inclusion Solutions really focuses on highlighting and bringing forth those values, and when that happens, the rest of community actually benefits as much as the actual individuals that gift it.
So what are the benefits of an inclusive community over a community that's not inclusive?
Great question. We work with a lot of communities, and I can absolutely say that the benefits are far-ranging. So for the individual, it's obviously connection, sense of belonging, a deep sense of contribution and ownership around the community as well. Obviously, massive mental health and physical health benefits that come out of being intrinsically linked within your community. And beyond that, for a community group, a sporting club, or the facility, if you like, the business where people can contribute their time and skills and talent, it's a massive amount of benefit there. So economically, we know that there's a significant diversity in different people's views and agendas and that sort of thing that they bring to the party. And more than that, I guess community-wide, it really impacts the whole of community. So social isolation is incredibly dangerous and harmful to an individual's health. As far as 15 cigarettes a day is a recent study. So being socially isolated is as detrimental to a person's health as smoking 15 cigarettes a day. So it's a really incredible stat, but really it's economic, it's cultural, it's a lot of tangible benefit to being inclusive.
So how do you go about starting to build an inclusive community? What does that look like?
Starting to build an inclusive community, I guess, happens through a range of different sources. Sometimes communities or a club or a sporting group might find us and seek out a bit of support. Sometimes it happens through a bad outcome or a bad instance where someone has been excluded and that matter's taken up. I think the best sporting clubs, the best community groups and the best organisations that we work with, the strongest and well-rounded organisations, really value diversity and really value the notion that people of a diverse ilk, whether that be a racial background that might be different to what they have in their group, or whether it's someone with a disability or someone living with some kind of mental health condition, the strongest communities really wrap themselves around those and really find a way to unearth that talent and bring it to the party.
I listened to David Engwich's speech earlier, and he was really talking about how individuals can have agency and put the eye back into being part of the solution for their community. If you were to give one bit of advice to people today about how they can go out today, do one thing to be a change agent to improve social inclusion in their community, what would it be?
I think it comes down to a great quote that I heard a long time ago now, but the quote basically says, "Oh, I was waiting for someone to do that, and then I realised that I was someone." So I think it's really around that notion that we all have the power to do it, and it really does start with that eye. So I absolutely value that sentiment from David and second that, and I think it comes down to that quote, is that we've all got power to do something about it. And probably the worst place to be is to not do anything, is to have a great idea and not share that and not bring that to life.
Great. Thank you very much. If you'd like to see more videos from the Power to the People conference, please check out our video library or the links in the description.